It seems fair to say that science is in love with what is called in statistics the main effect. This is a straightforward comparison among two or more groups to test whether or not there are any differences between or among these groups. The main effect has been a staple of scientific endeavor since the dawn of statistics, but main effects make a fundamental assumption that all members of all groups are replications of each other. They can be assumed to be identical, and that's simply not true. This leads scientists to try and create very homogeneous groups, or to use the general linear model to control differences statistically in order to create as if homogeneity that might not even exist in nature.
So for example, if you use an analysis of covariance where you're controlling for age, gender, and race, you end up finding a main effect for an ageless, genderless person without culture. Those people don't exist.
In clinical trials, this problem results in the conclusion that everybody in the group should get exactly the same thing. This leads to the furtherance of mass production solutions to helping. We saw this with the vaccines for COVID. Some people had no reaction to the vaccine, others experienced fairly severe symptoms. Alcohol abuse has shortened or ended the life of millions of people. I have a 91-year-old relative. He can drink any of us under the table. So, why are main effects popular? Because they're easy. They're easier to run statistically and they're easier to interpret. But that does not mean that they are more scientifically valid or are the only path forward. No matter how much you homogenize the group, when you're talking about the entire population, having these uniform ways of approaching intervention are not person-centered. We need to develop machine learning techniques that support the identification of interactions in large data sets. Some already exist, such as random forest. We need to identify anomalous cases. We cannot rely exclusively on main effects to support a system that is able to customize interventions based on the unique needs and strengths of people we serve.
This is the idea behind the emerging field of precision medicine, and that's our aspiration in our work with precision analytics.
This is not something that can be done routinely in clinical research. It takes very large data sets. To put it in completely different terms, main effects are equality. Interactions are equity.